Kimberly, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me. I love being here.
This is one of the best traditions of Christmas, of course, making Christmas cookies and decorating them. Now, I'm not extremely skilled in this, but you are, thank goodness. You're going to show us. Now, we already have these amazing smelling gingerbread stars. Oh, my gosh, just smell that. Amazing.
Oh, it smells so good. The snowflake cookies are one of my favorites.
Yes, and they're great to decorate because they're big. And, of course, you can get the cutout, what do you call them, the cookie cutters?
The cookie cutters.
Mm-hmm. Anywhere.
Yes,
any
and beautiful shapes and different shapes and different sizes. It's a really fun cookie
now,
to make
us,
with the family.
How can we make them look as beautiful as these gorgeous finished product over here?
Well, one of my favorite things about this cookie is that it's kind of hard to mess up. And one of the tricks is that we have one color scheme going here. We don't have thousands of options for embellishments and icing colors and things like that. So this is pretty easy to do. So if we take these bags filled with the icing, and there should be an open end here, and we're just gonna squeeze it so that the icing comes out, and we just line the edge of the cookie. You just follow the outline here. It's very easy to do, right? It's just a little Ziploc baggie, and you've got your soft icing in there.
Oh, that is so easy.
Right, exactly. And so anyone can do this. It's a great cookie to make at a party, if you're having a cookie decorating party, or with the family.
Uh-oh, I missed up. All right.
That's okay. It's gonna still look beautiful because you're gonna add all these pretty dusting sugars and embellishments on there.
Okay, I am amazed, because I thought I would totally make a huge mess. Well, I mean, you can make the thick, okay, I am making a mess.
No, you're doing great.
You can make a mess, and it still looks beautiful.
And it still looks pretty. It looks like a little ribbon you've laid all over there. I love it.
Okay, I'm sorry. You're
No, you did great, and now you can take all these beautiful embellishments.
Okay.
And just
these
sprinkle
are all,
them all over
you
as you like.
You can get anywhere. You can get these at the grocery store,
Absolutely,
right?
Absolutely, yep. But I like that we've stuck to one color scheme here. I think it makes for a really nice touch, and at the end, the cookie presentation is so pretty, right? Regardless of how messy you've made it, add some of those sparkles.
Yeah, these
those
are like
sparkles
bling
are beautiful
for your cookies.
Right, exactly. It looks like snow.
Yes. Now, also, every year, Southern Living Magazine, which... it's so beautiful, features
yes.
a Christmas cake.
Yes.
This one looks absolutely impossible to make for the average person, but you've got some really good news for us.
I do. So this is the first year, you know, we've had a white Christmas cake on our cover for, I think, over 20 years
yes,
now.
Yes, I still have my 1995 Southern Living hardback cookbook. It has a gorgeous white coconut
the
cake.
The annual recipe. Yes, and I remember that cake, actually. That's a fabulous mm-hmm. cake. But it's a tradition for so many families in the South to make the white cake that we have. But, you know, this one might be a little bit more time-consuming than some of the ones that we've had on there in the past. So, and the fondant icing can be a little bit trickier than regular icing. So this year, you can order the cake, and it arrives to you.
You can order this white cake.
Yes, it arrives just like this, frozen. I had one delivered to my home, just to so I would know exactly what it was like, and it comes just like this, and it's frozen and easy to embellish.
Okay. So, Kimberly, what about the ribbon, though? I mean, that ribbon looks impossible.
So it's fondant icing that comes with it. And it comes with easy step-by-step instructions, and I'm gonna go through a few of them with you, or all of them with you here today. So we've rolled out and cut this icing to look like the ribbon. We're gonna add a little bit of water to the back of our finger, or to our finger, and add it to the back of the white ribbon, and we're gonna add it just like that so we can get the stripes.
Nice, and it's edible.
Super simple. It is edible, but fondant doesn't taste very good.
Right,
so
right. This
I mean,
is mainly decoration.
It's more decoration, but the cake is fabulous.
Cake is fabulous.
I promise you that.
And even though it's frozen, once you just thaw it at room temperature and
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got this laid out. We're just going to do one easy roll over it because if you go back and forth, once you've got this pretty part like this, it can get a little bit messy.
Okay.
But we've got one ready for you. We cut off the end so that it really did look like a ribbon.
Ooh. Okay.
And we're just going to lay it on the cake. You know, you can give it a little curl or however you like your ribbon to be.
Oh, yeah.
And then the bow comes already like this, which is wonderful, because that could be a little bit trickier. You just place that on the top in the center.
Does it stick?
It'll stay. Okay. It will stay. And, you know, this is such a beautiful cake that it's really a nice thing to have out on a buffet or something like that. And when you present it, this is such a pretty cake stand.
I can do this part.
Right. But when you present it, you want to embellish around the bottom a little bit. So it comes with these peppermints all in, you know, the spirit of saving time during this busy time of year.
Okay. Now, we still have to put this one on.
You want to? Okay, sure.
And well, I just want to see if I can do this.
Okay, great. So, well, we want to cut the ends a little bit. I didn't do it in a very neat way here. But go ahead, why don't you put it on this way so that we don't see the messy end. Stick the messy end under the bow.
Okay,
and
so just
lay
kinda,
it on.
Just kind of curl it up like a...
Exactly.
Oh,
see how easy that was?
This is amazing.
Yeah, so easy. Nestle that down in there, and
wow.
There you go. You've
see?
Got... Your buffet will look like the cover of Southern Living magazine.
We can all be a gourmet thanks to Kimberly here, who has showed us how to do it. All right, well, Kimberly, thank you so much for being here with us
thanks
again.
Thanks for having me.
And Southern Living's latest edition, A Merry Southern Christmas, is available on newsstands nationwide. And if you're near a bookstore, be sure to pick up Christmas All Through the South. It has more great recipes and decorating ideas, and it's a perfect gift for you or your loved ones. We'll be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.
Thank you.
Thank you so
yeah,
much.
Yeah, you did great with everything.
Is that okay?